it. And that's exactly what it is. It's 9:22. I just did somebody's diaper change, right?
Hi.
Hi. And here we are on Coffee Talk, tracking the tropics. There are two named systems that we are watching. This is the first
Daddy.
One. Yes, buddy. You want to sit on my lap?
Coffee.
It's Coffee Talk. That's right.
It's so warm.
Okay. Yeah. Oh man, it's good today. All right, so here's the first one. This is Tropical Storm Laura. It's sitting over Hispaniola, which is good news because remember, if it's over land, he just found out how to turn the light on, so that's fun. If it's over land, it has kind of an impedance on its opportunity to strengthen. So good news for anybody in the future path. Bad news, of course, for our friends that live on Hispaniola because they're dealing with potentially life-threatening rains, flooding, mudslides. Remember, there are mountaintops on Hispaniola that are about 10,000 plus feet high, so about 2 miles high. Big, big, tall mountaintops. So that's definitely taking its toll on Laura. Here's a look at the forecast from the National Hurricane Center. When it comes to Tropical Storm Laura, expected to not only move over Hispaniola, but notice move over the lion's share of Cuba now, which would keep it a pretty weak system. We do think once Laura gets out into the bathwater, the jet fuel, he's playing with the lights, so I apologize. I think I need to take the lights down. But as it moves out over the just very warm water of the Gulf of Mexico, we do think that Laura not only gets more organized, but becomes a hurricane and potentially makes landfall as a Category 2 hurricane, as of the latest thinking from the National Hurricane Center, with winds on Thursday now, because it's taking a little more of a path of resistance because it's going over land. That's adding friction. It's going to slow it down a little bit. So now we're thinking by Thursday, it will make landfall early, early Thursday morning with winds of about 100 miles an hour. Yes, it's a rave, Cindy. You're right. He's just going back. I have two lights, and he's just going back and forth. Are you having fun?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Closing.
You are closing that?
Uh-oh.
That's okay. It's your help. It's your help on Coffee Talk, right, buddy? Are you my lighting director?
It's on.
It's on now, yes. Disco weather report. That's right. So Laura's definitely going to be a concern for many folks, not only in the Caribbean islands, but into Louisiana. And then there's the other problem, which is the other storm system. Here's the latest on Tropical Storm Marco. This is on the verge of becoming a hurricane because it is over the bathwater, because it is over that very, very warm water in the Gulf of Mexico. Here's the forecast thinking from the National Hurricane Center. Also a Louisiana landfall, but this one a little earlier. This one is Monday into Tuesday. So let's get this straight, okay? You're talking about a landfalling hurricane potentially on Monday into Tuesday in Louisiana. Then you're talking about a landfalling hurricane Thursday in Louisiana. As long as I've been in the weather game, I've done this 20 years. As long as I've followed the weather, which is more than 20 years, I have never seen anything like this. I mean, this is such a 2020 scenario. It's not even funny. I will tell you, as these come ashore, I will share video feeds from our sister station WDSU, which is in New Orleans, because they're going to have quite a week of weather. It's really remarkable when you think about it. I mean, when we think back here in Florida, 2004 is our bad year, right? Because we had Charlie, and then a little while later we had Francis, and then a little while later we had Gene. Imagine getting two in a week. Seriously, this is such a crazy thing. But here we are. So did want to make sure to point those two out. Marco is going to probably become a hurricane later on today. Whereas Laura has more land to go over. Now, let's look at the models on Marco. They're pretty tightly agreed that New Orleans is maybe not going to get a direct hit. Maybe it is, but it's going to be pretty darn close no matter how you slice it. Let's look at the computer models on Laura And they're pretty tightly agreed on the northern Gulf Coast. Most of them are taking it right toward the Texas and Louisiana border, but it's still in that vicinity. Let's hope that these two are at least not getting the exact same area at the exact same time. You know what I mean? Jody, good morning to you. How are the boys doing? Well, I've got my one is getting a diaper change with mommy. The other right now is playing with the lights. I don't know if you could tell the discotheque effect. But yeah. Giselle, Puerto Rico got Irma and Maria almost around the same time. Well, Irma was very different than Maria for Puerto Rico, but yeah, I see your point. And, you know, and perhaps the Caribbean is much more susceptible to multiple strikes. I'm meaning Gulf Coast states. Certainly the Caribbean will get one after another, but in the same week in the Gulf of Mexico, that's wild. I'm afraid to even think what else 2020 may bring. I did read about an asteroid coming near Earth the day before Election Day. I don't know. I don't know much about that. Any new storms coming off the coast of Africa? Let me just double check. It does not look like it, no. The waves, I'll show you the waves. Give me just a second here. Barbara, thank you. I try to be a great dad, but then again, you know, all I'm doing is letting him just play with the lights. So yeah, so what we're kind of seeing is the waves that have been rolling off of Africa here recently have kind of been fading once they hit the ocean, which is partially because if we look over at the Saharan air layer. No, buddy. No, you have to leave that. Okay. There's certain things you can play with. There's certain things you can't play with. So what's happening is you can first off, let's just take a look at what's happening here, okay? So first and foremost, this is the Saharan air layer. So what it is, the orange colors are the dust. Obviously, the satellite is kind of overlaid on top of that. So if we look here, you've got your tropical storm over land, not much Saharan dust anymore. We look into the Gulf of Mexico, certainly not much Saharan dust there. And then if we kind of come out to the wider perspective, if we go out to the open Atlantic, there is a lot of Saharan dust. So these waves that are rolling off of Africa are kind of running right into the Saharan dust and struggling to develop. So that's the good news for them, at least for now. Once we're done with these two, we may have a bit of a break as well. Thank you for taking your personal time to keep us updated. It's my pleasure, Bonnie, as long as you don't mind little Eric turning on and off the lights. yes, Juan, the Saharan dust can stop tropical system development. Absolutely. Alicia, I'm nervous they will turn in the Gulf. These should behave themselves because of the upper level dynamics. Now, Marco did have a pretty significant forecast cone switch yesterday because it rapidly intensified. And if we get into a scenario where Laura rapidly intensifies, then yeah, there could be a bit of a swing there as well. But either way, it's not overly concerning for us. Other parts of the Gulf Coast, absolutely. That said, I do want to mention there are tropical storm warnings in effect for much of the Caribbean islands. Tropical storm watches are posted for the Keys, for the Tortugas. And then if you look up here into the northern Gulf Coast, we've already started with tropical storm watches and warnings. Tropical storm watch for Mobile Bay. Warning, basically heading all the way out toward New Orleans and Lake Pontchartrain. Hurricane advisories posted right now are for the rest of Louisiana. Hurricane watches are in effect for Lake Pontchartrain. Hurricane warnings are in effect for basically the low country down here. So if you do have friends or family out that way, hurricane watch means hurricane conditions are possible. Hurricane warnings mean that hurricane conditions are expected. So certainly our friends in Louisiana are going to have a wild week of weather. Daryl, I saw one Euro model having Laura being a rainmaker across Arkansas to North Carolina, then reforming into something off the North Carolina coast by the end of August. Didn't have the long range. So by late August, early September, there is something long range cycle wise that should be developing off the East Coast and lifting north. So it's interesting. That may very well be. Laura, let's take a look at the raw model here. Hi, Stella. Sweet Stella. And I'm going to have to adjust the kind of camera view on this. So bear with me a few seconds. Hi, sweet Stella. I've got Stella and I've got little Eric. So it's a party, you guys. All right, so I'm going to do that, and I'm going to save that view. Stand by one. Oh, are you writing? Don't write on that. That's the hospital bill for your brother. Hospital bill? Do you want to pay the hospital bill for your brother, Eric?
Yeah.
You want to pay Winter Park Hospital?
It's hospital.
That's where I was born. Did you know that, buddy? You know, you were supposed to be born at Winter Park Hospital, too. But you decided to come super early. Can I see that, please? Can I see that, please? I know. We have to keep the pen out of your hand. I know. Here, buddy. Check this out. A toddler. He's throwing his toddler fit right now. Parents, you know what that's like. All right, so let's look at these computer models here. So we'll start with the GFS, and we've got located here, we've got Marco. Located in here, we've got Laura. Excuse me for just a second, please. All of that because I took his pen away. Parents, you know what that's like. So here's the models, okay? So watch through time, all right? So here we are. You've got Laura kind of lifting through Cuba. You've got Marco heading toward Louisiana. This is going to be early Monday. Looks like Marco will be making landfall. Then you've got Laura re-entering into the Gulf of Mexico. Getting strong. Now the model's seeing it getting strong, and it's heading, it looks like, to western Louisiana based on kind of current thinking. Lifting north, there it is, becoming rain into Arkansas, lifting up to the northeast. And then there, yeah, does that develop that far north? Does that redevelop? I don't know, but there's definitely that. And then let's just kind of look at the rest of town. Bermuda High's building in, nothing big. Although, yeah, so that's that. Let's look at the European and see if there's anything crazy. Roberto says, I cry like that whenever I get ready for work. Well, judging on the people Roberto has to work with, I certainly understand that. All right, so here we go. So there's Marco in the Gulf. This is the European model now. So there's Marco. There's Laura. Let's travel through time here. You've got Marco making landfall near Louisiana's New Orleans area. There's Laura riding along the shoreline of Cuba. And the European model is really developing. So it looks like, you know, if I'm honest, Marco looks to become a hurricane. Laura looks to become a bigger hurricane and make landfall somewhere in a very similar area. And then from there, kind of lift to the north. Interestingly enough, now that's interesting. So this is different. So this, the European model almost has it making a due right turn and traveling over Missouri and then heading out over West Virginia and Virginia and then rolling off the shoreline late August. So there you go. And that would continue its kind of genesis. It would go from probably a tropical depression here over the Smokies to become maybe a tropical depression, subtropical storm, something like that. Once it moves off the shoreline again, that would be wild. Not chaotic, but that would be a very 2020 thing of it to do. Yeah, there you go. Rebecca, Toddler Logic 101. You give it to me, it's mine. You take it away, I will hate you forever. Yeah, well, the problem is he grabbed it right off my desk. So, yes. Well, and he's also got this thing, too, where he just points at things and says it's mine. So that's always fun. So he'll just take dibs on everything. John, absolutely my pleasure to give you the scoop on these two storms. A reminder, here we are, almost done with the middle column of our storm names. So we're now almost two-thirds of the way through storm names. Is it possible Laura could still break up over the mountain terrain, what, in Hispaniola? You know, the official forecast keeps it pretty weak. It's at 45 miles an hour. You can kind of see it's almost done with that. When we look at the longer forecast, it keeps it weak over Cuba as a tropical storm. And then as soon as it hits the Gulf of Mexico, blammo, it develops it and strengthens it. Lindsay says, so the good news is swimming lessons shouldn't get canceled on Monday. Correct. I'm looking forward to taking... Eric, are you going to go to turtle class on Monday? Yeah. He said, yeah. So, yes. Turtle class, we will still be swimming on Monday because I do not have to work. I got my hair cut for nothing, you mean? let's see here. Will this make tornado conditions in Florida, Deborah? No. This is going to be far enough south. We are not expecting anything like that. Terry says, who would name a hurricane Nana? I know. It's like such a sweet name. I know. When I saw that name on the list, it's like, not my first choice. How 2020 would it be that Nana would end up being the worst storm of the year? Now, that's a good point, Christine. Nana, the like sweet grandmother name, ends up being the one that ravages a bunch of people. It would be very 2020 of it. Yes, Rich, the third wave and even the fourth wave that were rolling through Africa, as soon as they hit the ocean, they hit into some Saharan dust. So, yes, not much there. Shelley, so Florida is safe from these two storms? Yes. But, of course, we still have plenty of hurricane season ahead, so we're going to have to watch. You're right, UConn. Nana's going to be that Cat 7 that they said couldn't be done. Dean, since Marco will alter the winds and energy in the Gulf before Laura gets there, how accurate will the models for Laura be? Or do they incorporate the forecasted after effects of Marco? They do the best that they can. It's kind of like, if you ever listen to NPR, the show All Things Considered, right? They try and consider all things, right? Tropical models are the same. They try with All Things Considered. There's going to be external influences. That's why the models are just models and the forecast is actually a bunch of brainy people down in Miami coming up with their own try of the forecast. So, you know, this is going to be difficult. The one thing I will say is if you look at the models, this kind of gives us an idea. The timing is not going to be identical anymore. So Fujiwara is less of an idea because here we are. That's Monday morning and you already have this storm system. Marco looking like it's making landfall near Louisiana. And then behind it, because of the additional land interaction, it slowed it down. So then we've got Laura kind of a little slower, but strengthening. So yeah, the concern of the both of them kind of spinning around each other or, you know, upwelling is a concern, but it doesn't look like they're going to follow in the same tracks. It doesn't look like that. As a matter of fact, where is that? I've got this here. If you kind of follow them both, it looks like they're just crossing paths. So if that's the case, then upwelling is not going to be as much of an influencer, among other things. All right. Will either one hit the Keys? No. Laura should stay a little further south. The Keys will probably get some rain from Laura, but not a monstrous concern there. National Hurricane Center discussion places some doubt in Marco becoming a hurricane due to shear. Yeah, absolutely. But then again, also notice that Marco is very healthy looking right now. Yes, you can see some of that wind shear if you look at it. I mean, it's already on the cusp. I would guess that it'll probably become a hurricane. But if you look, do you notice all the clouds are kind of getting blown off toward North Florida? For us, it was all the cloud cover that we were getting yesterday was kind of blow off cloud cover from Marco. But all of that, that's wind shear. So yes, do I think that it will become a hurricane? It's right there. And it's got a lot of warm water ahead. So I personally think it will become a hurricane, but it may not get to be too strong. By the time Laura gets into the Gulf of Mexico, the wind shear will be lower. Claudette says, new here, what is upwelling? First off, welcome. We do this just about every day. I usually do it at 8 a.m., but such is life. But newborn at home means I got no sleep last night. And so, yeah, we weren't doing it at 8. Anyway, what is upwelling? So if you get a hurricane over water, especially in the Gulf of Mexico where the water is super shallow, it'll churn and it'll turn. That wave action, it kind of churns it up. And what that does is that pulls up colder water from the deeps and brings it up to the surface. And of course, tropical systems need warm water. So if you're pulling up the chillier water from the depths and bringing it to the surface, it's not going to give it as much fuel. So upwelling usually helps to contain tropical systems lower intensity. But, you know, the question is this going to do that? It's moving at a pretty decent clip, so not really expecting much of that. Rach, should have been a Marco and Polo, yeah. Eddie says, let's scare people with hurricanes because we got to sell more generators and fuel and grocery. Well, the cool thing is, I don't sell generators. I don't sell fuel. I'm not a grocery store. I'm what's called a meteorologist, and my goal is to inform. And if you think that my information is scary, that's your take. The idea here is to stay calm. Knowledge is power. So, yeah, no worries. Hurricane Karen coming this year. No, that was not this year. That was another year. Oh, my goodness. And if I had to deal with another one of those, oh, it's such a Karen. Let me ask for your manager. Come on. Ay vey. Ah, that coffee. That 88 degree, what did you say there, Daryl? That 88 degree soup in the Gulf sure is good for storm formation. It's true. It really is true. Little Eric will decide whether Marco will live or die. He's the king of the world at that toddler stage, like a Roman emperor. You're not wrong, right? I take his pen away and he's like freaks out. But that's just the way it works. Oh my goodness. Thank you, thank you. I enjoy the kids. Miss mine wasn't bad. Some people are just rude. Yeah, people are just rude. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. A great, great grandmother thanks you. Well, thank you, Sandy. Thank you for hanging with us. And thank you very much. I appreciate it. Oh no, ignorant people are ignorant people. I still have to throw a little shade every now and then. It is what it is. Joe. Oh geez, Joe. You're too funny. Thank you, Jennifer. I appreciate it. Let's see here. Knowledge is power, right? That's the way I look at it. Becky, thank you very much for watching from Puerto Rico. Hopefully everything went well with you as the storm system passed by. What's tropical wave looking like? There's really nothing else, just these two named systems, thankfully. Nothing else out there for right now. Wait until you take his phone away. Well, Susie, that's the cool thing is, with the way that you can do things, I could just turn the phone off through the provider. That way he still gets to hold the phone one day, but it just doesn't do a thing. It's a brick. You took his pen, Eric. Can't draw the hurricane forecasts on the wall, right? Oh, man, oh, man. It's a conspiracy. I know, George, right? We're all a conspiracy. We get on a conference call, and we talk about how, you know, we can ruin people's lives. Oy vey, Smear. Cat 5 potential with Laura? No. Look, is there a potential? There's always, I suppose, a potential. But I just don't think we're going to have enough room for it. Let's take a look, though. Let's look at the intensity models before I say no. Let's look at the updated intensity models. Stand by. Yeah, I mean, most of them are peaking it at about Cat 1 or Cat 2. Wednesday, Thursday before making landfall, so yeah. So what happened to the snake that was in the pool? I got it out. It was a little baby black racer. Yeah. Kent Sue Parsons, first timer. Thanks for just plain information. My pleasure. And I try to keep it absolutely as open dialogue as we can. This is me. You know, you're getting me. I'm sipping my morning coffee. I didn't shave for you. Didn't do my hair for you. I had to take a pen away from my toddler earlier. So, you know, this is, you're in my office right now, good, bad, or otherwise. Angela, I think you missed my comment about the pen. Take the insides out and put his name on it. He can't write on your wall. That's a good point. This one, though, is kind of sharp on the edge. I'd worry he'd still scrape it. But that's actually a good idea. That's a good idea. He was pretending to cut my hair because I had just gotten a haircut. So I gave him a tool to use. And he somehow figured out how to wrap that tool around his neck. And it's like, okay, all right, we're you're done with that one too. what's the future storm picture looking like? For right now, we're going to be a bit quieter. Once Laura and Marco make their way ashore, we're going to be a bit quieter. Here's the European model. You can kind of see there's Marco, there's Laura. So Marco comes ashore first, then Laura works into the Gulf of Mexico, and then after that, we're actually quiet. Except if, you know, this plays out and you get the storm system to roll back off the shoreline. Yeah. No, Jeanette, these are not going to converge into one superstorm. Richard, hello from San Antonio, Texas. Love this show as a 14-year-old, 15 in September. Well, happy birthday. Almost there to enjoy. Thank you very much, Richard. Hey, listen, bud. When I was your age, I was a super weather nerd, and now I get to live the life talking about the weather. You do now have to deal with trolls, you know, internet trolls, but it goes with the program. Richard, if you have any interest in it, buddy, you can do it. I'm telling you. So cool. Very cool. Stay up to date. Learn and learn and learn. And shoot me an email if you ever have any questions. All right. I don't know that I know anybody in San Antonio doing the weather anymore. I used to, but I think that they've moved on. Robin, weather has never been a thing for me until I came across you in Coffee Talk. Well, thank you, Robin. I appreciate that. Teachers start face-to-face Monday. Glad it will not affect us. Pray for us. Absolutely. Some teachers have already been in the classroom, but yes, glad that these storms are not adding to our local stress. But then again, our poor friends and family from Texas to Louisiana all the way to like the Florida Panhandle are having to watch these. So unfortunately, there are still people that are going to have to deal with this. Rebecca, any chance Laura could pull a Charlie and turn northeast at the last second? It's unexpected. If Laura, like, missed all of that land, that could have potentially been a thing. But for right now, no, because Laura's not going to be able to be as strong. Charlie, if you remember, here, I'll show you the... So take a mental image of this. So where's Laura? It's over... It moved south of Puerto Rico. It's over Hispaniola. It'll be moving over Cuba and then getting into the Gulf. Let me show you Charlie, okay? It's a good question, though. So here's Charlie. Charlie was much, 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 much further south. Much, 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 much further south. It missed all of that land up there, remember? And it kind of made that right-hand turn. We knew it was going to happen. And it kind of rapidly intensified once it hit the loop current north of Cuba. But notice, what land did it go over? It really missed Jamaica. It missed the Caymans. It crossed over a fairly flat section of Cuba. And then it made its way to Florida. So it's a very different spot. It's a very different positioning. Very different storms. Very different storms. Hi, buddy. Do you want to hang for the end of Coffee Talk? The P-E-N is out of his reach, if you know what I mean. Let's see here. Positive thought of the day. Double hurricanes lead to double rainbows. Hey, you know what? I'll take that. I didn't hear about that, but I'm going to be honest. Yesterday afternoon, I was kind of doing just family stuff. I was in the pool with Eric and... but I didn't see any tornado warnings, but my gosh, that's crazy. Let's see here. Well, that's it too, Lisa. If he follows with the pen, yes. I'll take quieter anytime. Exactly. There you go, Tiffany. I like that idea. All right, listen, my friends. If you missed anything on Coffee Talk, watch the replay. You won't be able to ask the questions, but at least you'll get the information. I think we talked about just about everything. Also, if you want to watch Eric doing his discotech lighting, because he learned how to do the lighting at the beginning of Coffee Talk, you can, you know, watch like just like that. You can watch the replay. All right, my friends. Bob's asking, have I ever heard of Tom Skilling? The legend? Absolutely. All right, my friends. I'll pop on to Facebook Live if need be later today for stronger storms or if there's a crazy something that happens in the tropics, which I don't think will be the case. But anyway, listen, be the sunshine in someone else's day. Thank you so much for hanging out for Coffee Talk. I'm going to go play with my little guy.